If you don't mind, we'd like to play something for you. One, two, three, four.
Came a long way from Guitar Hero mics. I was growing up alone, trying hard to decipher the meaning alongside walking through life with my hands on my head and my heart in a visor. Something crushing, I've been on the up and up and up again. Hunting something I don't know the name of through my ugly limbs. I'm wondering, wondering, where did I go? Wondering, wondering, where is my ghost? If I died a long time ago, where would it go? Cause I don't feel alive in this world, but I'll cope through drugs and escapism. All that I know is I don't feel satisfied living alone. I don't feel satisfied being myself, no. I don't feel satisfied going through hell. So I arose in the morning with a true hope in me, trying to bring change like the new Pope simply. Never understood why my crew coped with me till I realized they were all a few clones of me. And that's fine, long as these rap lines make me fun dude to be around, they'll still stay. See, then my fan base doubled in a month while I slept all day catching rest, y'all say. But truthfully, I was so stupidly sat in a state of anxiety, spewing these raps from my mind to the paper to you and then back, till it no longer sounded like me on a track. When I listened to it, my issues had exited, took the express from my brain to the exodus, traveled for miles on a path through my head, discovering questions and asking them. When my friends came knocking, I'm in bed, Azzy, pretend I'm dead, saying Alice isn't here, he's traversing his regrets. No, Alice isn't here, he's reversing the effects of friends come knocking. I'm in bed, Azzy, pretend I'm dead, cause Alice isn't here, he's just searching for his meds. No, Alice isn't here, he's obsessing over death, saying.
See, the moral of the story is, I guess, that things are gonna get better, and then they're probably gonna get worse again, but in the long run, the better times tend to outweigh the worst ones. And I'm not a philosopher, or definitely not a genius of any sort, but I am a well-spoken rap artist on the internet. From experience, I can pretty confidently say that shit's gonna improve somehow, so just do what you gotta do, I guess, you know, like, do what you gotta do. Make yourself happy, as long as it's not illegal. That's a debate for another time, whatever, I'm out.
Second, its display was eclectic in a way that was second to none. He had a hand that swam like fish in the seas, and a pin stroke that bring any critic to his knees. It was beautiful, flowing like the blood inside my arteries. He painted hearts as targets and was practicing his archery, mastering the artistry he carried in his chest, until at best it was a godsend, and worst was a part of me, till suddenly things began to seem different. Moods dissipated into blue and gray pigments, but surface-wise, his screen names were never inefficient as a method to communicate that happiness was with him. So a couple thousand people saw a perfectly innocuous complexion while I was trying to talk him through depression. The lesson to be learned is that your heroes aren't invincible, just normal folks who often need expression, so pause and leave a message. If you want, they'd probably appreciate it.
Internet personas. Internet personas we hide behind. We hide behind. We all got demons deep inside us. Demons deep inside us we try to hide. We try to hide. And I forgot who it is I truly am. Long ago. But I'll keep searching for it while I can.
I knew a person who could cultivate the words that they align in a way that could coerce a train to fly. A perfect state of mind in which to learn creative rhymes until their person wasn't burdened by the verses they designed and they began to lose their touch. The little quirks in all their writing became terse and uninviting, and ingesting any lettering they surgeoned into life instead of being entertainment was inert and just absurd, and all the work was fucking tiring, and suddenly they were writing less and less. In spite of their success, they saw no light and second-guessed the creativity they harbored in their heart. There's only so much fucking artwork you can make till you forget the way to start. So a couple million people saw some dipping in the frequency of music while they fought idiosyncrasy. They slept as mental illness and woke as some peculiar trait of thought that masqueraded as a symptom of a hindering delinquency. I hope that all these words have made you think of me. Internet.